My husband Ken and I are going to tell you the story of our dining room table.
You're going to tell the story. I'm just going to make some comments along the way.
Exactly.
Okay.
Really interesting though, local resources, local artisans all together to make this beautiful, beautiful piece of furniture.
You did a good job.
And well, you helped. We had a vision for our table. We wanted it to be slab, we wanted it live edge, we wanted all these different details. And the only place we could really find them were online, and you really couldn't see them in person, and the shipping was crazy. So we're online looking for slab wood to maybe assemble it ourselves. And we find Ohio Woodlands down in Saleenville, Ohio, just south of Lisbon.
Right around the corner.
The owner, Jared Caldwell, gets on the phone with me. I tell him what I want, the dimensions I want, and he totally understands
he
what we're trying to do.
He even had pieces of black walnut laid out. You know, you told him the dimensions, what you generally wanted, and we went there and visited. It's got a great piece of property out there, and it was really interesting.
So my search for the black walnut slabs brought me right here to Ohio Woodlands in Saleenville, Ohio, owned by Jared Caldwell. Had exactly what I was looking for with the live edge. And this is a family business, huh, Jared?
Yeah, it's a family business. We started about 4 or 5 years ago. Basically, what we do on the farm is we basically salvage any lumber that comes down. We come from a history of forest management as consulting foresters in the past. But basically what we do, when a tree comes down on the property, we salvage it and we bring it to the sawmill.
So the trees go down, you reclaim the wood. What are some of the native species that we see in our area?
Well, in Ohio, you've got a whole bunch of different species that are available. On our tree farm, we have approximately 30 to 40 different species that are prevalent, ranging from cherry, like you see on the mill here, to black walnut, to oaks, to maples, to some of your understory species we even cut into, like ironwood, serviceberry. We've got ash, we've got cucumber magnolia. It's a very abundant source of trees here on the tree farm.
And which are the most desirable that people really want to purchase when they're looking for wood, probably to make furniture or things of that nature?
Your basic species that are the most desired would be your maples, your black walnuts, your cherries. This right here is actually considered crotch cherry. It's actually where the tree branched out. We do a lot of untraditional sawing on the property. A lot of times a traditional mill wouldn't do anything with this, but this is a type of tree that has a lot of figure that wood artists and furniture makers actually desire. And with this slab, you've got what's considered a book match. When you open it up, you have the exact mirror image from here to here. And once again, this is green. It's gonna dry, it's gotta dry still, but this is basically what you'll have with possibly a tabletop or anything that any furniture maker or woodworker might wanna have in the future.
So book matching is important to a lot of people when they're creating.
Some people won't buy anything but book match. Some people don't care at all about a book match. It's just simply what the woodworker or wood artist wants.
So from this point on, then we'll go to the kiln for the drying. Pat Crow is the woodworker who made the table. And of course I had to bring him on the field trip because he absolutely fell in love with the black walnut. So you had to see where it was born.
Absolutely. When I saw those slabs, I was really impressed. What I remember was that they were really straight, really flat, and needed very little work before we had to clamp them up.
So drying the wood in the kiln is really important to keep it straight, to keep it from moving when you're using that for woodworking.
Casey, absolutely. One of the most important parts of the woodworking process from sawmill to end product is the kiln drying process. When you work with a wood that hasn't been kiln dried, you're going to have problems with probable cracking, stress fracturing in the future. So the kiln drying process puts it through the problems before any future problems would happen. Basically.
And what kind of percentage are we looking at? Because you'll see like different percentages, like kiln dried, 6. What percentage are you looking for when you do that?
Basically, from sawmill, what you saw with a fresh cut slab, you're looking at anywhere from 30% to 50%. We're trying to get it down to approximately 6% for indoor furniture work.
It is absolutely breathtaking. And this is all based at the Coldwell Tree Farm. Your family business is based in here. How many acres are we talking here?
Casey, we have approximately 600 acres here. It's all PEFC certified American Tree Farm System
wood.
What
does that mean?
Basically, it's a certification of hardwood products. For every tree that we actually market, we're planting at least 30 to 40 trees. We plant about 3,000 to 4,000 trees per year here on the tree farm. We believe in sustainable forestry. It's very easy to do. You treat the farm right, and it treats you right back very well.
So now we're gonna go and look at your wood.
That's what she
said. eBay is where I met Jared. I went in and put in slab wood to see if anything was out there that I wanted in the black walnut. And you came up and I found you were in Celineville and it was awesome. So this is some of your inventory of the things you sell through eBay and Ohio Woodlands.
Absolutely, Casey. This is basically, it's a high and dry place, a good place to store dried lumber. You've got some matched red maple here with a pretty good amount of what's called spalt. A lot of the wood artists and furniture makers are looking for that unique look that you can't find at your traditional Lowe's or Home Depot or Carter Lumber. I'm just trying to provide a product that people can have their own individual piece of nature that's been taken care of and sustainably harvested.
I mean, so many choices. I mean, what are the different woods we're looking at right here?
Oh, in this little stack right here from right to left, you've got a yellow poplar straight grain mantelpiece to a matched dining room tabletop, red maple to some mulberry to some oak to some matched curly cherry behind there. On down, you've got a little bit of matched walnut, some matched wild apple. I try to get about as any species that I can get a hold of on the property. I try to mark or to cut it up and put it online via either eBay or OhioWoodlands.com. This is actually a walnut crotch piece. This is very desirable because of the figure. When you look here, this is just the kiln dried slab without anything on it. And it goes from that to a nice starburst style look with a little bit of water. And when I market the product, I market it with the water on or mineral spirits to show the woodworker what the wood will look like with an actual whatever type of stain or varnish they decide to put on it.
So the first step's done. Mm-hmm. Now we have the wood.
Now what to do?
We've got to get it assembled. And during the holidays, we're down at one of the art shows at Ward Bakery. And we meet Patrick Crowe. And he is the final piece to the puzzle. Right. We explain to him what we have in our living room, sitting there waiting to be assembled, bench, table, slats.
And he was totally able to make your dream a reality, right?
Totally saw the vision, came to the house, was not overwhelmed, took our wood away, and then delivers this beautiful table.
He did a great job. Look at that. It begs to be touched.
Up next, wood artisan Patrick Crowe shares the techniques used in making the table. Pat Crowe is the local wood artisan who made our table a reality. And you have a lot of experience with the live edge, don't you?
Yes, live edge means that the boards still have the shape of the outside of the tree from which they were cut. And also, we kept the bark. And that's the thing I really like about the live edge.
And you're going to be assembling a lot more of these tables, aren't you, Pat?
I certainly hope so, Casey, after you sell them for me.
But really, you did such a beautiful job, and you really do appreciate, you know, the different characteristics of wood, and you really do treat it with such finesse.
Well, I have to say that the slabs were really easy to work with. They needed very little redressing to make them clean and straight enough to put together as a table, and the flattening took very little time also. The base took a great deal of work, but that came because you and Ken were such good customers. You guys really knew, they really knew what they wanted. And we went over hundreds of pictures and many, many different designs, drawings, and even a few bad models that I made. And we got to a point where we came up with a solution that I think we all really love.
I absolutely love it. And really, I mean, your appreciation for wood just shines through this table. You can really see that you truly understand all the different nuances, and you've really done a beautiful job.
Thank you. I love the table. I love doing it, and I'm glad you're happy.
Patrick displays the different features of wood and shows how they are enhanced through his finishing skills.
This is one of my favorite woods. If you see, the bark is like a camouflage. You've seen it around rivers, but that's quarter stone sycamore, and it's got the pronounced ray flex. But to get that look in a piece of wood, to bring that out, I have to use a two-step die stain process, and that's how we produce this. Similarly, that's how quarter stone oak brings out the mission style furniture, where much like Frank Lloyd Wright's work or the mission style, it looks like grandpa's furniture. This is a slab of the walnut. It's been air dried, unlike Jared's, who does kiln drying. But this gives you an example of what the walnut looks like before finishing, before even sanding. And then here's an example of the bark. Very rough, very flaky. And what I did on Casey's table was work hard to save that bark. And you'll see that in the finished product. What we're looking at here today is a couple of bookmatched pieces of beech hardwood and bookmatched quarter saw, meaning that it was sliced from the center of the log. And if I open these up, you're gonna see pronounced ray flex. And those are radial vessel structures within the wood that produce what are just called flakes in the wood. This is a very good example of ray flex in a piece of beech. And up here at the top, it really comes to a crescendo. This is a piece of walnut that I got. Again, this was cut off the side of a log to allow the sawmill to create straight square boards. And those aren't the kind I work with. I like working with curved work that is live edge, as we saw in Jared's woods. So I'll get my vacuum on here. And here goes the sander.
And the monkey said, six. I could not think of a better group to invite to my very first meal at the table. Jared, his fiance Carly, of course Ken and Patrick, and my girlfriend Melissa. Let's all dig in and let's enjoy this beautiful table. Cheers.
Cheers.
Mmm, yum.
Oh my God, that Casey Malone show is the best! She's the absolute funniest person I've ever met in my life.